Hello. Hi, everybody. This is Tiffany, and we are coming to you from my kitchen and Jillian's house because technology is awesome.
Yes.
And today we are going to talk about a couple of different things. Let me just make sure that they can see us.
Okay.
I can't tell using this if they can see us.
Okay.
And we'll wait for some people to get here.
Okay.
I'm waiting to see. Let me pull it up.
Okay. Well, are you pulling it up on Facebook?
Yeah. She said she sees us. Okay.
Yay.
Awesome. So we are there, which is perfect. Hi, everybody. We're going to be talking today about basically like working more efficiently, having your site work for you, even when you're not on it, and getting you followers on all the different platforms, because you want to be taking that opportunity at every chance that you have. So we're going to be talking about that. My guest today is Jillian from Catch My Party. Jillian has been part of SITS and the journey that kind of Francesca and I've been on since really early on. Did you speak at Arizona, Jillian? I was trying to remember.
I think I spoke at Denver.
Denver. But she's been in the space forever as an influencer and blogger. And was really I would call you kind of an adapter early on, as far as like cultivating content and having people, you know, submit content to share and be a resource for, parties and things like that. I mean, I've used your site a number of times, in the past, and it's so great because, it really like lends itself to Pinterest and Instagram and photos and, that's kind of where we're going to go today with talking about how you can be building those platforms while you're not working, while you're at the pool having a nice
time. Exactly.
Because I know that's my end game, right? Having all the work I've done continue to work for me when I'm not at it.
Yes.
So we are going to get into that in a minute, but I'm trying to... Give me one sec because I want to see. I want to make sure that if anybody's talking to us,
that we can see it.
We can see them. So I'm jumping in there right now.
Okay.
And if you're here, leave a little comment, say hi. Jillian and I, of course, have known each other from boot camp and the blogging in general. And then we literally both turned a corner at Mom 2 in May, and we're like ran into each other face to face.
Yes.
And it was so great. Like,
it was.
It's really the reason that you go to conferences. The networking with the brands and all that is, yes, totally important. But just seeing the people that have been, you know, part of your tribe it's just everything. It's just so important.
I just have to say, I have to agree, which is yeah. I go to conferences and I think I know what I'm going to get out of it. And then I always get something else out that I didn't expect, whether it be meeting you, whether it be learning from somebody who I didn't know about, making some sort of connection. And there is something to knowing lots of people online, but as soon as you meet them in real life, you have this connection that is different.
Yes.
And so I have a podcast and it's called the Blogger Genius Podcast. And it's interesting because almost all of my guests I have met, I know them. And so when I email and say, hey, you want to be on my podcast? There's like, I know they'll say yes, because
right.
they know me in a different way.
Yes.
And so you will be on my podcast very soon. So, but it's that idea of like, oh my God, Tiffany, please come on my podcast. And because you know me and you've seen me and you've talked to me in real life, it takes It takes the relationship to a different level.
It really does. And you know, it's like people are rooting for you. You know, like when you told me about
Milo Tree.
Yeah, Milo Tree, the plugin. I was like, this is amazing. Like, can you come in? Can you talk about it? Like, the influencers need to know about this being out there, because there's nothing better than a plugin that was actually created by an influencer, especially an influencer that truly has traffic. Like, you have a established website that's legitimate.
Yeah, we get millions of page views a month. So yeah, we are the largest party ideas site on the web. And I say this to people, which is, if you're a mom with kids and you're planning birthday parties and you've gone to Pinterest ever to plan a party, whether it be a Spider-Man party or a My Little Pony party, chances are you've been on my site.
Yes. So keep in mind when we're talking about this, you're getting information and ideas and advice and recommendations from someone who's done it, who's built the site. You know, I always say to people, like, be really careful about where you spend your money. You should absolutely spend your money and invest in your site. But I often find, you know, business coaches who haven't really grown a business significantly.
Yes.
And, you know, we were talking offline about, you know, a lot of these plugins and apps are developed by, you know, a 22-year-old guy who knows coding, but doesn't know what mm-hmm. it's like to actually run a site that we're running, that women and creatives are running. So
exactly. So just to step back. So my husband and I, he's my partner, he's the technologist. We built Catch My Party. And we built it into the largest party idea site on the web. And of course, a ton of our traffic comes from social media. So what happened was, we were getting a ton of traffic from Facebook. And this was back in the day when you could post and everybody who followed you saw what you were saying. And then all of a sudden Facebook's like, wait, we need to make money. And we're going to kind of like turn the spigot down. And all of a sudden we're watching our traffic go down because so much, we were so reliant on Facebook. And we're like, oh no. And this is the thing about being a blogger and being an online entrepreneur, is if you are not scrappy and you are not okay with change, this is not the business for you. But if you are scrappy and you are willing to Google things to learn about them, then definitely do this. You don't need an education from Harvard. You can educate yourself. So we look at each other and we say, oh no, what are we going to do? And then what we noticed was, we were getting traffic from Pinterest without even trying. And we were getting like real traffic. And all I was using Pinterest for was when I would be writing blog posts and people. So Catch My Party is a site where people can upload their party photos and show off what they do. So it could be a mom in Arizona. It could be a party planner in New York. But if people want exposure, we want to give it to you. So what I would do is, I would use Pinterest to pin photos that I could then use in blog posts. So I was really just using it for me. And then all of a sudden we were getting traffic, and we thought to ourselves, okay, Pinterest is important for us. We need to double down on this. So we built a pop-up that we installed on our site, and it popped up and it said, hey, follow us on Pinterest. And at that time we were starting to get real follower numbers. And what it did was, it populated the Pinterest, was the pop-up was populated with our pins. We didn't have to design it, nothing. It just showed what we did. It showed the kind of content that was on our Pinterest page. So people didn't even have to click to our Pinterest page to see it. They could just see it right there. And it started working, and we started getting lots and lots of followers from it. And then our traffic started really growing on Pinterest. And as an entrepreneur, the thing I would say is, when something starts working for you, go toward it.
Yes.
So in fact, you don't need to go, okay, Pinterest is working for me, Instagram's not working for me, so I should double down on Instagram. No,
right.
Definitely have a presence on Instagram. Be open to it. Be reading about what's going on. But you double down on the thing that is driving you traffic or creating sales for you. Focus there. So that's what we did. And then, of course, we're saying, well, what if we're so reliant on Pinterest? Oh, no. But then we thought, you know what? We're scrappy. So if that's, you know, if we're getting traffic from Pinterest, great. We want that. If ultimately it changes, we're going to change with it. And that's what we did. So we used this pop-up. It grew our Pinterest followers phenomenally. So what it does is it sits on our site. You come to our site. In fact, if you go to Catch My Party right now, you will see it. And it will pop up and it will say, follow us on Pinterest. And you click on it. It will send you to our Pinterest page. You'll see that we're the real deal. And chances are you will follow us. I think it has a conversion rate of somewhere between 80 to 90%. Now, then we thought, okay, Instagram is becoming popular. What are we going to do? And we thought, well, what we'll do is we'll use the same pop-up, but we could program it so that it would pop up and it could say, follow us on Pinterest, or it could say, follow us on Instagram. And it's going to populate the pop-up with our most recent Instagram posts. And guess what? It started to work. And we started growing our Instagram following. So we currently have something like 850,000 followers on Pinterest and over 150,000 followers on Instagram.
And that is that the tool that is that your basically your strategy for growing it?
Yes. So we don't spend any money on growing it. We don't buy advertising because again, we monetize Catch My Party via traffic, mostly via traffic. So it doesn't make sense for us to buy ads to bring people to our site because that we need thousands of people right. to come to our site to make, you know, $5. So this is definitely the best way for us to grow. Anyway, so then we said, you know what? This is working. So one thing that I want to say is people say, oh, but pop-ups, they're so obtrusive and I don't like them. Well, so to address that, one, they do work. It's the truth. Pop-ups work. They do convert. But we created our pop-ups so that it's not obnoxious, so that it is subtle and noticeable and effective. And that's how we built it. Because again, we're publishers. So right. we care about our user experience. We're not just saying, you know, we want you to have a good time coming to Catch My Party to find what you need. And we also want to grow. So we have those two goals. And how do we balance them? So we're always working on that balance.
I think too, what's important when you mentioned, you know, oh, I don't like pop-ups. Your blog and your real estate, I look at it like you are offering this service to the reader for free. They're coming to you, they're getting their ideas, you're making it a one-stop. Here's how you plan your Lego party. Here's how you plan. And for me, the pop-ups that lead me to Pinterest or Instagram, it makes my life easier because I'm not searching for the icon.
Right.
Or I might not even be thinking, oh, I want more of this. And the nice thing, you know, is it's one stop, you do it, click, click. And yours also grows email, yeah?
Yes. And which, again, yeah, sorry. So what happened?
A lot of people have neglected their email lists.
Exactly. And so what we do, so not only can you now grow email with it, you can also grow your YouTube subscribers and your Facebook followers.
Wow.
And that came from people telling us what they wanted us to build. So what happened was after we did it for Pinterest and Instagram, we sat back, my husband and I, and said, I think that we could help other bloggers grow their Pinterest and Instagram followers using our pop-up.
Right.
And so I went to a conference. Again, this is where the value of conferences okay. comes in. I went to Blog Her Food in Austin.
I did too.
Were you there? Okay. This was the one in Chicago. I also okay. went to the Austin one. And all I did was I made a postcard. And I said, I'm Jillian from Catch My Party. You might know me, you might not, because these are food bloggers, so it kind of fits in our space. And I said, we created this pop-up. Please try it. See what you think and give me feedback. And a couple people signed up. And they signed up. I think we gave them something like 1 month free, but they paid for it, which is always a really valuable thing, which mm-hmm. is I could give away something and people might use it, but can I get people to actually pay for this?
Right.
And so people did. They signed up, they got their free window, and then they started paying, which made us go, we're on to something here.
Yeah.
That people, this is of value to people.
It's of value, exactly.
And so then that's when people would say, hey, we want it for Facebook, we want it for YouTube, and we want it for email. So we built it. And so therefore, it's one pop-up. I want to just say one thing, which is, and we were just talking about this before we got going live, which is bloggers wear so many hats. It's like not only are you a creator, and not only are you a photographer and a graphic designer, and maybe you know some coding, and maybe you know some Facebook ads. Like, you have to know so much. And I think the most difficult part for me, and I have these two companies, is the technology. Which is, I don't, as soon as that happened, like, oh, it just, my heart's like, my stomach drops when there's some sort of technical issue. So we built Catch My Party for bloggers, meaning it is simple. It's simple to install. We offer a WordPress plugin or a line of code. We're here to help you, but there are fewer choices. We said, if we can make the choice for you, we're going to do that. And probably 9 times out of 10, we're right. So you can trust us. And therefore, you don't have to worry about it. You can set this up in 3 minutes. There isn't all of these, you know, what am I going
to
do?
Give it to you don't need to wait and hire someone to install it.
No, in fact, we get that feedback all the time, which is we want to be the anti-feature pop-up. Like, and it's weird because there's this concept when you're developing products, especially technology, called feature creep. Where you build something and then you go, wait, but we should offer it this way too. And then we should do this and then that. And that my husband and I have to stop each other and go, no, right. How can we simplify it? How can we take these features out that people aren't going to use and just make it easy?
Mm-hmm.
Because the feedback we get is bloggers are overwhelmed for time. Time is their most precious resource. It's not even money.
Right.
Money's up there. But it's time. Where do I spend my time?
Yes. And I think that is where I see influencers who, you know, they're spending their time and not their money. And unless their blog is only making them $5 an hour, something like this is a no-brainer, right? If a subscription to MiloTree is $9 a month, okay, so that would be, if let's say an average blogger makes $75 an hour when you break down, like, you know, when they're working on sponsored content or whatever. Mm-hmm. And for many, it's more than that. Mm-hmm. So this is like 15 minutes.
Exactly.
Of the entire month that you would be paying for. So it's kind of a no-brainer, the time that it sits to take. And you're also then, and when you're doing this, you're not playing follow, unfollow. You're just getting legitimate.
Yes.
Authentic, real followers who saw your content and said, I want more.
Yeah. So the thing is that because remember back in the day when we were starting and people would come to your blog and they'd come to your homepage and they'd see what's new and they'd read your blog posts and they'd comment and you'd comment back. And it was like these destinations that you would go to. And now, because of social media, for example, Pinterest or Instagram, let's say, you're popping into sites. You're seeing a recipe. You want that recipe. You go to that blog and you might never come back. And so like 80% of your traffic is one time in and out. And the goal for MiloTree and for bloggers in general is how do I create a relationship with that visitor so I can get them back to my site so I can show them who I am and why I'm special. Build that relationship, maybe get them on my email list or at least get them to follow me on Instagram. And maybe a year down the road, I've created a product and I can then sell that product to them. So it's much easier to build a relationship than to continue to try to get new visitors who are going to come in and come out.
Yes. The building of the relationship is still happening.
Definitely.
You know, it used to be like it all happened on the blog. But the relationship is still happening on Pinterest, and Instagram is basically a micro blog. I mean, you're still creating rapport and sharing that your creativity, and now Stories has upped that even more with people. So this is really one stop, one plugin to increase all of your following across your platforms without a headache of it. And when we were standing in the hallway and Jillian's describing it to me, what, you know, we don't do a ton of, you know, products. It's not really our thing. But when I came out of Mom 2, LaShawn and you were were two people that I was like, we have to share this information, because working smarter is imperative.
Yes.
Because you can't, you think of the 3 or 4 hours, let's say you spend an hour a week, which I know is actually on the low end for a lot of people, building your platforms. That's 4 hours a month. What you could do with 4 hours a month, when we're even using this on the Sway website, like when we heard about it, we were like, okay, yeah, this sounds perfect. It's installed. It's there. We love it. It's just a no brainer. It's so easy to use. And it's created by a blogger, a real blogger who's been in this for 10 plus years.
Yeah. It's funny because people will, what I always say, and I said this to you, is we eat our own dog food, which is our pop-up is super important for growing Catch My Party. We would not have been able to get the number. We were not one of those Pinterest accounts, you know, in the beginning. Pinterest, kind of the Pinterest gods shined the light on certain accounts and they grew to millions of followers. And then you find those people and eventually the story comes out like, oh yeah, I was one of those recommended pages. We were never that. Ours was slow and steady. And it's because when someone comes to our site, they're warm to us.
Right.
They're like there because they clicked on something through Google, through Facebook, Pinterest, wherever. And they're there already kind of, and again, we try to serve up good content. So hopefully they're liking us. And then they're more apt to go, oh yeah, I'll follow you. And remember, asking somebody for your email address, asking somebody for their email address is a bigger ask than asking them to follow you on Facebook.
Totally.
So again, it's like, well, you might not want to give me your email address, but it's not that hard for you to follow me on Instagram. So
a lot of bloggers sometimes forget to focus on non-bloggers, on people that aren't part of our day-to-day community. And the people that find you on Google, you know, those people aren't worried about their Instagram ratio. They're following whoever they like. They're following Reese Witherspoon. They're following Jennifer Gardner. They're following Kristen Bell. They're following, you know, the mom next door and Catch My Party. And, you know, those are the people that they are giving away their likes. They're happy to do it because they like the content and they're not, you know, we're so conditioned to like, oh, I don't want to like too many people. Don't worry about that. Like, you want to grab on to whoever is visiting that site. They already came to you. And if they liked what they saw, they want more. And it makes their life easier to get more on the different places that they are. Oh, there you are.
I'm back. Hello. Yes. And in fact, I think that's such a good point because we do get very myopic in our blogging world. And weirdly, we start to think the world is small because it's only these 6 bloggers that I follow that I like, you know, that I'm watching.
Right.
And the world is so much bigger. And your customers or your visitors are those people that you are identifying. It's the mom down the street. It's the mom in Alaska. It's whomever. It's not some influencer who you hope will follow you back.
Right. A follow.
Yes. And to just be thinking about your business as serving up, it's not weirdly about competing with the other influencers. It's about serving up something that somebody wants. It solves a problem for somebody who hopefully you identify with, you know, that is like your avatar.
When your 8-year-old comes and says, I want a Fortnite party, for to be able to go to one spot and get all the ideas that you
need. Absolutely.
It's a service. It's helpful. And the more that we position our sites as a service and a problem solving to people, the better our longevity is.
Oh, definitely.
Those things won't ever go away. People are always going to be Googling for certain things, you know? And blog won't, that's why, in my opinion, the blog won't be replaced.
Blog will not be replaced because you own it. You own it. You don't own your Instagram.
Right, exactly. And that's you want to drive people, who are, if they're coming from Instagram, you want to drive them from the blog. If they're coming to your blog, you want to drive them to the other platforms and, of course, to more of your posts. We have a question. It says, I lost it. It was basically, Can you set up the pop-up so that more than one platform can be selected for follow?
So the way that it works is, and again, this we built with our users, with our customers. You set your pop-up how you like, and you can add as many platforms as you want. If you have two Instagram pages, you could add both of them. And what it does is you prioritize. So let's say right now, Pinterest is most important for us for Catch My Party. So we set it that the first pop-up that shows up to everybody visiting our site will be Pinterest. Then the pop-up will go to sleep for however long you want to set it. And we do that on purpose because we, again, are very conscious of not inundating our visitors, that they're not annoyed. Okay. So if you have traffic that is one-off traffic, you could show your pop-up more often because chances are those visitors aren't going to see it that frequently. Right. If you have traffic that comes by every day, you want it to go to sleep for maybe 5 days in between so that, you know, people can get a rest from it. Then though, when that visitor comes back to your site the second time, whatever pop-up you put in position number two will show.
Got
so
it.
That so way, I think, they, yeah.
If they take the opportunity and follow you on Pinterest, they don't see it again?
Right.
Great. Okay.
So what will happen is it Instagram. If you've rotated through all the pop-ups, then you will get back to the Pinterest pop-up because we can't tell who has already followed you.
Okay.
Because that happens on Pinterest. It doesn't happen on MyLotree. So we don't have access to that data. However, you set up Instagram, Pinterest, Facebook, email, that person has to be coming back lots of times.
Right.
And they will see each different pop-up. So you can kind of think about it if as a drip campaign.
Yes.
Which is it's one ask. That's the other thing. People are like, can I have multiple pop-ups in one visit? And we say no, because again, we care about your relationship with your visitors. So it's one ask, simple thing. They can do it. And then the next time they come back, they're asked something else. So maybe they're not ready to give you their email.
Right.
But so they don't sign up with their email. But then the next time they come, you're asking for their Facebook, you know, for them to follow you on Facebook. Okay, I'll do that.
And so you get time they come to you four times, they're going to be a lot
exactly.
more if you give their email. The other thing that I think is so interesting about this is you actually could also play with it in the sense of maybe you set Instagram to number one for a week or two.
Exactly.
And then you switch it and go to Pinterest and see where your audience is interested in seeing you.
Absolutely. So one thing that we find is, so because we have this big Pinterest following and Pinterest drives traffic, a lot of times then somebody finds us on Pinterest, comes over to our blog, and we pop up a thing that says follow us on Pinterest. It is a no-brainer for them. They've already seen that what we have good content on Pinterest. So we have this feedback loop. So you want to find these. Where are your most engaged visitors? And exactly what you said, which is it's super easy to switch it around. It's like one click where you can move how you set up your own pop-up. So let's say you decide you really want to drive people to your list because you're going to launch something. Well, put that first. And then once your launch is over and you really realize that Instagram is important for you, switch it and then have Instagram show first.
There's another question.
Yes.
Does this count as the sort of pop-up that Google doesn't like and penalizes for, or no, because it's unintrusive?
I love that question. Okay. So Google came out about a year and a half ago and they said, we do not like pop-ups that are intrusive on mobile. They want the mobile experience to be good. This does not involve desktop, probably most of everybody's traffic is mobile. So it was funny, again, because we care about our pop-up for our own business. You know, I started getting emails going, have you seen this Google announcement? And I'm thinking, we have so seen it. Not only have we seen it, we're already on it, because they gave you a window of time before you adjusted your site and things like that. So what we did was we built a Google compliant pop-up that is smaller, that shows up on mobile, and then a larger pop-up that shows up on desktop, and you don't have to do anything because we can tell where your traffic is coming from. And so if your traffic comes on mobile, which means phones and or tablets, we show a smaller Google-friendly version. If your traffic comes on desktop, we'll show a bigger version. So we handle, that's again, one of those situations where we're like, we don't want people to have to install two pop-ups and no, we'll do it.
I think the other thing is, again, because you're using this on your own blog that makes you money,
yes,
you have to stay up to date. So you're not going to be worried about scrambling after somebody that developed a pop-up a year ago and now isn't paying any attention to it. You know,
exactly. Like, we are so on it. We, you know, GDPR. So right. Our email pop-up is GDPR compliant.
Right.
Because we have to be. And again, it's now, that.
Yeah. There's legislation coming out in California that's going to be similar to GDPR. So being on top of that and knowing that visitors in California are now going to possibly have to give permission. And what does that look like?
Exactly. So again, the thing hopefully that like when we saw each other and you're like, oh, this sounds really cool. And you know me, like, you know, my business, you know, we're very transparent. We're very open. I always tell anybody they can reach out to me at Jillian@catchmyparty.com or Jillian@milotree.com. And I answer every email. So we've built our product with our customers, with our users,
right,
because that matters to us, you know? So we're always thinking, what's the next thing? And it's funny because we feel like we're zigging when other, like, let's say pop-up companies are zagging, in that we want to take all of the complexity out rather than add complexity in. And that comes direct. Now, again, could my husband handle complexity? You better believe it, because he builds our products. But he recognizes that that is not where our customers are. You know, they don't want more bells and whistles. They want something that's going to work from the start. And what I will tell you is, if you have traffic, it will work. It will grow your following. It just will, you know?
Yeah. And I think that this is, if you're at that spot, you know, I know I was telling Julian earlier, some established bloggers, they have it figured out. They like what they have. But if you're at that spot where you get traffic, again, the people do have to come to the blog for them to decide that they want to follow you. They literally have to be at your blog. But if you have traffic coming to your blog and you don't have something set up that works while you are not paying any attention to it, and this idea of a drip system where you're hitting them when they come back, I mean, that's what we do in sales. Mm-hmm. That's what people who want to connect and keep the relationship, this is how they do it. Mm-hmm. They do it with multiple reach outs, right? With multiple reminders. Hey, we're here. We're also over here. We'd love to have you. And the idea that it's created by bloggers, like you and your husband have seen this, you've seen this whole continuum. And the fact that this idea came out of like Facebook changing, all of us remember that.
We were freaking out.
What's happening?
Yes.
That's the magic of technology, right? That mm-hmm. that there's this creative push that comes right after we feel like we just kind of got slapped in the face.
Oh my God. Yes. And
that it's just, if you're at that spot where you know that you need something different than paying a virtual assistant hours to follow and unfollow and try to work the Pinterest game and get these followers, this is what you want to try. One, you're going to spend less money and less headache. And it's every single person is going to be authentic. Every single person that comes from this will have gone to your site, seen what they like, and clicked.
Absolutely.
And so they are your customer. They're already your customer.
Exactly. So you have to think about your traffic as kind of an asset.
Yes.
You've gotten this person to your site. And then almost like you don't want holes in your bucket. Like, you want to be able to hold them, like, go, I've caught you. I've got you. I've got you in my universe.
Yes.
And my universe looks very different, say, than it did 10 years ago, because I have all these possible ways to reach out to you. And one other thing that I always say is, do not assume that your audience on Instagram is the same as your audience on Facebook. Do not assume that the people on your email list are also subscribing to your YouTube channel. So you have to be thinking about each platform slightly differently. There might be I'm sure there is some crossover.
I would imagine, actually, I would say this, between Instagram and Facebook, there's probably minimal crossover many times, because Instagram is where we're finding younger
Yes.
And Facebook is where we're skewing a little bit older.
Definitely.
And so to cover those, and I think, you know, my friends that use Pinterest as how they plan their parties, how they plan their recipes, how they potty train, you know, all those things, they're kind of their own breed, right? Like,
yeah.
They jump on every day. They know what they're looking for. It's their search engine.
Exactly.
You know, it's their search engine. And you want to come up everywhere you can. And also, many of us, we're diversifying what we're posting where. What we post on Instagram is often not the same as what we're posting on Facebook.
Yep.
So they're not seeing double content anyway.
Yep. Yep. You know? Yeah. Yeah. And this idea somehow, like in the beginning, the idea of like, oh my God, what if I did post the same thing on Facebook and Instagram? Chances are very few people are going to know. And if they, let's say they saw it twice, would they even notice?
No.
Or, you know, no, again, this idea that it
takes three to, I think they say between 3 and 8 exposures before anybody actually acts.
Exactly.
So you want to be hitting them different ways, different times. Oh yeah, I meant to check that out. Oh,
right.
I meant to check it out. You know, in the beginning we were flipping out that Mark Zuckerberg knew that we had just looked at, you know, some handbag, and now we're like, oh, Mark, thank you for reminding me I need to buy that birthday present.
Absolutely. Like the assumption I think is that we're all busy, especially moms are super busy. So any way you can touch somebody with a little bit of help or a little bit of something entertaining or something beautiful, like all of those things make somebody's life a little better. If you're just spammy or whatever, no, but chances are as influencers, as creators, you're creating something that is of value.
Yeah.
And the more you can touch people with that, the better. And the other thing is that people say, well, I don't have a lot of traffic. Why should I use this? And it's interesting because I had a conversation with an influencer about this, and she said, oh my God, I've used this from the beginning because I have had a couple of posts on Facebook go viral. And thank goodness I had this on my site so that when I got that traffic, it wasn't again like the bottomless bucket where all of those people just fell through. I was able to start to capture them. So that is an investment.
It's going to happen, totally.
And she said, I had no idea, but thank God I had it on. I think what happened was something went viral. She didn't have any way to capture that audience. And then that audience went away.
Right.
And so she's like, I want this because the next time this happens, and then it did happen again, she was able to capture some of that, those visitors.
Yeah. Laura, I know I talked to my son's high school class about marketing and influencer marketing, and they were Snapchat all the way. They said they don't even text. It's either Snapchat message or Instagram message. And all of us on Facebook are apparently old.
Old. I know. And in fact, it's funny because again, we listen to our visitors, and when Snapchat really came on the scene, that was the next pop-up we were building. However, with Instagram seems to have, especially for influencers, I don't know how you feel about this from where you're sitting, but Instagram is the most popular pop-up that we serve.
Yes.
It seems to be kind of taking over the world right now, which is cool. And so, yes, do you want to grow your Instagram following? Sure. But also remember that, you know, 2 years ago, Snapchat, or a year ago, it was going to be Snapchat. So again, it's this idea of being flexible, being nimble, you don't know, like we don't know, you know,
and you can't in this industry, you can't just build it and walk away from it. You have to automate it to keep up with the changes and keep up when Facebook changes an algorithm or decides they're going to change policies on how content can be delivered. And you know, with Snapchat, I thought the same thing. There was a while there that we were like, should we start creating Snapchat campaigns? But you know, because you really can't get the analytics from it, and it truly is a younger base for the most part.
It is.
We haven't had much ask for it. And so Instagram right now is definitely where it's at for when it comes to sponsored content. However, Pinterest, for many, many, many influencers, you look at Instagram like as, okay, this is something I want to build because I want to get campaigns.
Yep.
And then Pinterest, you need to build because you want the traffic. You want definitely the traffic on Pinterest.
Definitely.
In fact, you're going to your blog and then you're getting ad revenue and, you know, all those things together, being thoughtful about all those things is what helps you diversify that income.
Absolutely. So you'll notice on Catch My Party, we show our Pinterest pop-up first. And we do that on purpose because we monetize, again, as I said, we monetize via predominantly traffic. And we also, though, do sponsored posts. And so therefore, our Instagram following is important to us, but they're different. They serve different purposes. But of the two, we make more money via ads than sponsor content. So we're going to lean that way. And so it is very important, not just for a Milo, you know, setting up your Milo Tree pop-up, but for your own business to really think about where are you making money and where do you want to be making money? Because if you don't like doing sponsored posts, and you like traffic, don't focus all of your energy on Instagram, even though every influencer you know is doing that. Every competitor of yours or, you know, the other food bloggers are growing Instagram. Step back and ask yourself why, and does this make sense for me?
Because Instagram is not going to necessarily lead back to your blog. Pinterest is. And so that's ad revenue right there. And being smart about it again and saying, okay, I want to focus more on ad revenue. What does that look like? Mm-hmm. And mapping out, where is it coming from? Where do I need more of it from? Or, you know what? I want to get some big campaigns. I want to start, you know, getting trips and things like that. Okay, I need to focus on Instagram because that number is what's going to impress and get a yes.
Absolutely. And also let's say I am a YouTuber. So remember, Milo Tree has a YouTube pop-up and you can subscribe right there on the pop-up. So if subscribe, again, if you're wanting to work with brands and you're a travel influencer and you have a big YouTube following, again, and that's where your money, always think about it as where's your money coming from, not what are other people doing?
Yes.
Because like maybe you think they know something I don't know. Like no. Get back to what matters to you. If you are trying to put money on the table for your family, just go that way. And the other thing too, which is interesting. So again, as I say, we monetize mostly via traffic. By growing our Pinterest following, we also show up in Google search. Our Pinterest boards show up in Google search. Yes. So Pinterest has become a big part of Google search. And so again, there's that overlap. And when we discovered that, we want to go deep into that. So we care about SEO. And so weirdly, our pop-up serves our SEO strategy.
Yeah. And that's what it is. It's a strategy and being thoughtful about the strategy and how you want to work it. What order do you want to put these in? What's the space going to be between them? And just experiment. Experiment with it and until you find your groove. That is much better spent time than going out and just searching hashtags and liking people and then having to go back 4 days later and unlike, you know.
Exactly. Absolutely. And again, do those tricks work? Sure. They work now. Maybe they won't work in another month. Again, it's that idea of just being flexible.
Yeah.
And that, but that does take a lot of work. And the one thing that I love is every day, I can see how many followers we have gotten on Pinterest, and I can see how many clicks we've gotten on our pop-up. And as I said, almost all of those clicks turn into followers.
Right.
And it's so when I'm sleeping, our followers are growing. And that to me, like there's nothing better than that. That's, because again, it is about, it's like automate where you can and focus your energy both on what brings you money and what you really like and what you're
developing good. Developing the content that's so good that they come back again and then they like you on Instagram, and you know, delivering the content to keep the people coming is the best place to spend your time.
Absolutely, because chances are that's why you got into this, not because you wanted to research hashtags.
Exactly. Right, exactly.
And it helps you not burn out.
Yeah.
Because again, as I said, there are so many things you could be doing. And I don't know about you, but I find this too, even being at this for so long and sitting where we're sitting, you know, I sometimes will sit down at my desk in the morning and be like, I need to do these six things. I don't even know where to start. because they're all different and I'm not sure which one's going to pay off. And I wanted to try this or who knows. And it can be overwhelming that I'm like, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to check Instagram just because my brain wants to explode. So anytime you can put something like say, this is working and I don't have to think about it. There's a concept that I think is really powerful and it's called mental load. And my husband and I talk about it a lot, like you're busy doing stuff and then he'll want me to answer like, do we need more milk at the grocery store or should I go to Trader Joe's or whatever? And I'm like, mental load. Like it's just too much.
I don't know.
I can't answer it. I'm like, you answer it. And so
I said that to my son. I've been like, I can't even answer that question right now. I can't even think about that.
Right. Cause it's just too much. Like you reach a point where I start shutting down.
Yeah.
And so the goal is to find ways, shortcuts so that you don't, so you have the energy to do the thing that you are super passionate about and that you can worry about hashtags later. And also for anybody who wants to try Milo Tree, we offer 30 days free.
Okay.
So there's no risk. And then you can, you know, it's $9 a month. You can cancel whenever. So we really, we want only people who want it. You know, there's no trickery, no nothing. It's all just about, is this working for you? And therefore we want to provide a really good service. So
good.
That's
so great. I'm so excited for you. I, you know, watching you develop and really nurture Catch My Party and now this, it's so great. I'm thrilled for you. And
oh, thank you. And Tiffany, you will be on my podcast talking about influencer marketing and all the stuff that you guys do. And I have watched your journey from the beginning. And I said to you last time, I'm like, please bring back Bloggy Bootcamp.
I know.
Because I will tell you that really legitimized our path.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't, it was so, this was this conference that Tiffany and Francesca did. And it was so rich in real value. I used to like leave, it was like 2 days. And I remember I used to leave and it'd be like, my brain would be like, pfft. Because it was do this, do it wasn't just like, let's all hang out and talk about how great it is to be bloggers.
Yeah.
It was like, here's how to grow your blog. Here's what you need to know, you know, do this. And like that, again, you reduce my mental load because you just said, this is what's working right now. I can't tell you it's going to work in 6 months. And I think I went to 3 Bloggy boot camps.
Yeah. It's been, I mean, every time that I run into people, they'll be like, hi, how are you? When are you bringing it back?
Yes. Yes.
I know that baby kind of disrupted things.
I know.
I can head back to it, but it was so great to talk to you. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, reach out to Jillian directly. We've been using it. If you have questions, you can email us. We can get you in touch with her. Whatever you need, the link to the plugin is in the description. It's also in the comments. And I really, if you try it, I'd love to hear your thoughts. I know
yes.
Jillian too.
And I would. And again, you know, we've built a lot of this has come out of feedback from our customers. So if you have feedback, I'd love to hear it.
Yeah. So that's where you can kind of find us. And still have your notebook from Bloggy Bootcamp. I love that. All right. Well, everybody, have a great day. Thanks for joining us. And we'll be back soon. Bye.
Bye.